Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Gamescom. We are here live at the ESL studios in Cologne, Germany, with the final map of the day. The final map we're going to see today of Group D here.
Yes, one of these two teams will not make it through the group stage. It's either the Australian Vox Eminor, or it's going to be the French-Belgian Titan that just took a loss to Cloud9. And if anyone took from that game that Titan couldn't have won it or somehow sort of not a fit team, you definitely have the wrong perspective. Because any inch, any slight, you know, grain of sand on the scale towards Titan, and they would have won that game. Yeah. That was so close.
And they had, I mean, they had a couple of those grains go their way with just the round that Hiko 1v3 clutches, man. And that is just that grain of sand was actually just what was left on that defuse, right?
So if Scream hits the last bullet on Hiko in that 1-on-4, Hiko's on 8 HP, Titan probably win the game.
Yeah.
That's I cannot how believe close we just saw
it's
that.
It's just details, down to the details. But now we get to see Nuke. Nuke is going to be the deciding map here between Vox Eminor and Titan. And once again, we find ourselves in that position. This is the loser match of Group D. This is going to be the last team to go home today.
So after a loss like that in double overtime, you are ahead 11-4. It is going to take a little bit of time before you mentally recover. Semla, how long would you need to get over a loss like that? And I'm talking about matchmaking. I'm talking about you playing in a $250,000 tournament.
A week in the Bahamas with some cute girls and lots of drink. And I might be able to recover a little bit.
A lot of drinks, right? Yeah. You know, an unhealthy amount.
I might be all right after that. And then I can be like, okay, let's go back to it, guys. It's all good.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking too. That is the kind of and right now what they've had is what, half an hour to get over it.
Yeah, I mean they have had 20 minutes give or take, half an hour. I mean still it's just like you have to be able to bounce back. But one thing we can say is that Titan, they are familiar with this situation. They have they have Nyack, one of the best managers in esports. They have the whole team, the experience
on
this team.
No burn intended, right?
Yeah. No experience, the experience on this team, really, this sort of situation they can bounce back from. And they are going into a match that, versus Cloud9, it's anybody's game almost. I mean, Titan are favored, but just slightly. Versus Vox Eminor, Titan are the pretty clear favorites. Like, they really are. Vox Eminor, they are the underdogs of this group. They put up a fight versus Dignitas, took 9 rounds
on
Dust 2. But
which
they
is actually
couldn't
pretty
actually
good.
Take it. I mean, versus Dignitas, versus one of the teams that you look at is potentially one of the top 4 teams of the world right now.
And a really good team on Dust 2, too. So
Vox Eminor, they put up a strong fight. Now, I mean, you're right, Anders. It's like, have they had enough time to be able to recover here?
Well, and the reason I bring this up is because I definitely think on any normal day, Titan on this map will definitely beat Vox Eminor. The problem is if somehow they do not get off to a good start and they keep tilting, that is going to be a big problem. Hopefully it won't happen. Or if you're a Vox Eminor fan, maybe it will. We do have a lot of Australians tuning in. Now we're in the game. Let's get ready. This is the ESL 1 Cologne 2014 tournament. It's only the first day, guys. And tomorrow, we're going to be covering all of the games in the second half of the group stage. So we will not miss any games tomorrow. It's all going to be covered right here on the channel. So you've got to tune in for that. And we still have quarters and semis and grands. This is so good. Now let's get it on. Titan gets a start on the CT side of Nuke, which is heavily favored. And Vox Eminor, they're going to have to really show us something a little bit above their A game right now.
Yeah, they have to get this pistol round is what we're saying right now. And this is 3 guys with Kevlar, a couple nades to work with here. Havoc already taking a peek towards that main entrance from Squeak.
Okay, that smoke is a really, really good. That's cool. That means we definitely already know Vox Eminor have done their homework. Because it takes some practice throwing that smoke that lands on Heaven right here. And Scream is going to give it up and just fall back. Titan are actually not getting the right read right now.
No, they think that this is going to be a ramp play, it seems. I mean, they've rotated 3 guys over here. In fact, they're really just trying to move around, get eyes on that lower site. Not really sure, because they see 2 guys out in yard as well. So they can think, okay, they're down through secret, right? And they're going to be working their way through long. Instead, it could be an A play here. It's all over the place. Vox Eminor, are they going to manage to find Smiths? Or is Smiths going to find them?
Oh, the bomb does go down. Smiths could have picked up a kill there, but right now it's a 4-on-4. That bomb is planted, and there's Smiths with the kill. Takes down Sponge now. It's going to be a 3-on-4 hold here from Vox Eminor. That bomb is already planted, and it's actually taken a while now. Top Gun goes down, and it's JKS alone. 1-on-4. He's going to pick up the 1 kill, but the bomb is already defused. In the smoke, they managed to get it done. So unfortunate for Vox Eminor, and he's going to survive the round, which is pretty important. Does manage to save the body armor, so it's going to give him a little bit more to work with. Unfortunate round there for Vox. That could have probably worked out.
That could have probably worked out. Then again, that could have been over just as the bomb goes down. Smith takes a peek from Toxic, right? And I thought for a second that Vox actually had, like, the perfect mind game going where they were just going to like wrap all the way back around onto upper site where nobody from Titan is. But they do commit to that lower site, and this is something that we see Titan do fairly often. Put a guy in Toxic and just leave him there. Yeah. And if it turns into a B play, they have Smith. He's waiting. He's in the perfect position to deny the plant, and the round just goes easily Titan's way past that point.
Now, while we do have this anti-eco coming out from Titan that they should be able to pick up, Vox Eminor not really invested much into, maybe we should actually, Kenny's going to pick up a kill, and that's a team kill in the middle. That's really bad. Havoc losing 3,300 for that, so that's going to be actually a huge problem going into the next round here. But I thought we should do this, because we know Titan, obviously, Smith's assistant, MBK screaming, Kenny is, but for anyone who doesn't know Vox, then it's Top Gun, Havoc, Sponge, and AZR, and then we have JKS as the new member on this lineup. Mm-hmm. And I mean, from the Dignitas match, I think the guy to watch has got to be ACR.
Yeah, definitely. That, we were really impressed with his play. He was hitting shots left and right. I mean, we talked a little bit about it during the Titan Cloud 9 match, but AZR versus Dignitas, I think he had like a 76% headshot ratio with like 13 frags, which is just ungodly. And he had some really sick rounds. So we'll see if he can do the same here on Nuke. We can definitely expect Vox Eminor to be looking to him to get some work done. But Vox, that's really going to hurt them. Havoc getting that kill like that on his own teammate, costing him so much money, basically nullifying that round.
For him at least, and that's a big problem. Scream here could get caught off, but the bomb goes down, actually down in that B bomb site. So pretty cool movement coming out here from the Australians. It's now 3-on-4, and they actually do have body armor and a C-set on JKS. He's going to get the kill on MBK, and now things are starting to look a little bit scary here for Titan. They will pick up the kill eventually. The bomb is already pretty far ticked, and they do have two kits to work with. Let's see if they can make it happen.
AZR, he's drawing his attention over to Ramp, and there you go, gets one kill, trying to stop the plant, and he's gonna barely get it. Kenny S, he's gonna go down. Vox Eminor save the op. That afterplant situation, Vox Eminor get a clean sweep of Titan. They get a birthday gift, basically the gift wrapped up there by Kenny. That couldn't have gone better for them. Unless they won the round, unless they managed to kill Kenny S in the smoke.
Yeah, but Kenny was very committed to it. That's still not a good time for Titan, because now Vox Eminor actually will have not just AWP, but AKs all around. And Titan, if they lose this round, they're going to be forced to eco. They just spent everything buying this round, so that's a little bit worrying. And Vox Eminor not going for any kind of crazy rushes, just taking it slowly in lobby, out on the silo, and wall banging through. That works! ACR! Picks off Smith, that's right for the wall, in onto the catwalk inside.
Yeah, AZR up there so quickly. He heard Smith's walking, and then there you go. You get a freebie, and this is what we're talking about. This is why we got to keep eyes on AZR. This guy is capable of ruining Titan's day. He nearly did it to Dignitas. Now he's got a second crack at it. Havoc out in yard, though, going to take a peek towards Existence. Not going to land the tag, but still, it's going to force Existence to give a little bit of ground.
Kenny is actually all the way down to 39 as well, and he's up here, which is a little bit scary. If he misses a shot from this position, he could go down immediately, but Existence is there to help him out, takes down Havoc. Kenny scoped up, and he's going to pick up the shot there on Top Gun, goes for a second one, takes down ACR, and now they're pushing in towards the ramp where NBK is holding Sponge, the only one left here. Good defense coming out from Titan.
Yeah, and even manages to make it around the corner. Existence is going to come in and mop up, get two frags for himself. NBK with the one, Kenny with two. And that was a very solid hold coming in for Titan, especially considering that was Vox Eminor's first buy. They got gifted an AWP. They had all the gear they could want, but they never really seemed to manage to get any kind of momentum there. They just kept getting picked off one at a time by Titan. Well, in Kenny's case, too. But still, the damage was done, and Titan are just looking very solid now on this CT side after that rocky third round.
And that's important, obviously, stabilizing immediately. There was a bit of a worry that maybe if they lost that round, who knows what would have happened, but it's good. This is a good sign for Titan, and especially if you're considering how many ups and downs you're going to have in a tournament like this. If they can make it back emotionally and mentally, that's a sign of a strong team, and they definitely are.
It's like, okay, there's the pop flash. Screen is completely white. Smith's vulnerable as well, putting shots through, just spraying madly. He's going to get one. Finally gets another one, perhaps. Yes, he does. He's got the USPS. He's still going to work. And they are just getting obliterated. Vox Eminor down to Havoc. He's picked up the two frags that Vox has, but he's still alive in a 1v3.
Yeah, wants to put down the bomb, but really doesn't have much of a chance to do it. As soon as he does, they're all going to peek him from three different angles. Fakes it even the once here, but they're so close, and he doesn't really know it yet. So another fake coming in, and Smith says that's about enough. Triple kill here for him, and And Vox taking a long time to realize there was a guy up on the rafters inside. And that really cost him a lot there. Smith with the first two kills when he was up there definitely made a big difference.
Definitely. I mean, the smoke worked his way. That smoke going down to block off Squeak, Vox couldn't actually look up at him. In the meantime, he's just spraying at random down into it because he saw one guy. He's like, okay, I know I've done some damage. I just need to keep spraying. Vox, just no idea how to deal with that. And as soon as they do come out of the smoke, it's too late. The rotation has come through for Titan. So Titan, they managed to keep it together. Vox, because they've lost so many rounds at this point, they're going to be able to put together a buy. But it's not... I mean, it's not as many nades as they would like. They're still going to get enough to form the corridor out in yard, though.
And Vox, I'm not showing us that they have more tricks up their sleeve here. They're going down to secret really quickly. And that's something they haven't done before so far. So it's nice to see that they keep switching it up here on the terrorist side, looking for new openings into the Titan defense. And that's exactly what they want to do at this point, because it's still early in this first half, and they might as well test out as many possibilities as they can.
This is the most clearly CT-sided map in the pool, essentially, here. Nuke, we expect the T side to get four, if they're lucky, five rounds, right? So if Vox can, they still have plenty of room to work with in this first half here to get those four rounds, those five rounds that they would need. Titan, however, the pressure is still on them because they're the ones who want the clean sweep. They need to make a statement right here after that match versus Cloud9 that we are not to be taken lightly, gentlemen. And we are going to get that spot in the consolidation match tomorrow.
The timing here in the vents is pretty incredible, both for Smiths and JKS. That could have been really close at Smiths. Comes out on top, going to walk right into ACR, who's waiting up there, who takes him down. But this is still not looking good for Vox. Now it's a 1-on-3. Havoc going to go down. Scream with a really good double kill. And we'll make it 6-0. So, another attempt from Vox didn't really work out the way they wanted to, as once they got downstairs, Kenny found one of them with an AWP, and that gave up a large part of the game. All of a sudden, Vox were sort of discovered, and they had to figure out something else, and they didn't really pay off. So I'm wondering what they're going to show us next. Right now, they will have to eco, but I like the fact that they keep trying new stuff.
Yeah, well, you got to keep it. You got to keep it varied versus a Titan. Titan are a team that will pick up on tendencies. They will be adjusting. If they see you doing the same thing over and over again, they're gonna make damn sure that they know how to counter it. So you have to keep Titan on their toes, basically. Now we actually have a round of eco coming out for Vox Eminor. So Titan are actually holding these rounds fairly well, and they're keeping quite a few people alive. That's the most important thing now. They've got quite a bit of bank going into these rounds for the rest of this half. So Vox Eminor kind of missed that window of opportunity where they could get easy rounds off of Titan by forcing ecos.
Yeah.
Now life is just it's a dark place for Vox Eminor. You know, they come from Australia. They're used to the sun. We have to see if they can deal with it.
I mean, hopefully they can. They actually had all the makings of what was going to be a really quick A push there with blowing up Squeak and throwing in a smoke to main, but Titan had just Molotovs everywhere. MBK going to deal with the first player, but does go down to ACR, and then Existence shows up with the AK. Kenny's downstairs as well to pick up another player, and things are not exactly looking good. But this is an eco round. Can't really expect all too much. I'm looking for the next one. I want to know what the next trick is that Vox have.
Let's see. Kenny S is actually going to claim a nice shot there. That was actually... Seems, but going into the eighth round now, 7-0 for Titan. This is really when Vox Eminor, the pressure starts to mount. They're going to get two big rounds here. If they were to lose this one, they're still going to have enough money left over, as we can see, to get a full buy in the next round. So this is where the pressure starts to really mount here for Vox Eminor. We're talking about having time, still being early in the half, but now we're starting to get into the mid-game of the half here, and they have yet to get at least one round on the board. So they want to have at least one round here in this mid-game before they start going towards the late game. They need to make it happen. And by taking over yard again.
And they're playing really aggressively. That's the thing out in this courtyard. Wondering if that's going to come back to bite them. Existence guessing. Kenny down here waiting for Spongin, and we'll take him down just like that.
A very clean kill there for Kenny, and it's so tough to predict where Kenny is going to be. Titan making sure that Vox can't exactly get a read. You could imagine Vox are going to think, okay, he's going to be up in garage again, right? He's going to be holding there. We're going to have smoked him off. No problem. But then, surprise, he's holding long. He's holding that angle. So Kenny is a nightmare when he starts to get rolling with that AWP. That's definitely not something Vox Eminor want to allow here, as they are now down a man. They have yet to find a clean way in.
MBK holding in here. It's going to be falling back quickly. Could have actually gone down then, so it could have been an opening if they could have managed to pick him off really quickly. That would have been nice. But MBK is playing this smartly, making sure he just, you know, falls back to the next position where he's able to hold once again here. And if they try and come for him, well, they're in headshot range, and there's the first one going down. Kenny there to support. Havoc is now gone, and JKS is going to be alone here looking for a pickoff, and he's only going to get the one. So really nice defense from Titan. And now I'd go for something I know Vendetta would be happy for at this point. I'd really love for a straight A push. Now, the problem is Titan have been throwing in Molotovs to try and stop them.
Yeah.
But they can smoke off one of those Molotovs, still go for it. They can, or they can just push through and hope that Titan are too confident in those Molotovs. So yeah, blow up Squeak, smoke off towards main, and then go for that A bomb site.
Exactly, get those flashes out there. We've already seen that they can land those pops, but what is this? It looks like, oh, well, maybe we have a main split coming in here. They're gonna get two guys up on main. They've already blown the door off of Squeak, and they're just gonna go jumping down onto main roof. KDS has been exposed. He still picks off JKS, picks off Havoc, could get a third. He's gonna get caught, though. Sponge lands the headshot, but this is now falling apart for Vox Eminor. They need to get another frag here, bring it back to a 3-on-3.
Top Gun is very low on health as well. That is gonna be a problem eventually. And they are sort of just standing still right now, really, really hoping that someone from Titan is gonna look the wrong way at the wrong time. It might have been existence here, but he does catch out Sponge. Now, grenade to follow will bring him to death. In fact, that's a 42 damage grenade. A second one lands on Top Gun, and now ACR is alone. 1-on-4 here, and this is not good.
This is Titan just saying, we don't even need to see you to know where you are. And, well, we know all about bombardments and
homing grenades, right?
Yeah, well, you know, bombardments in Belgium and France, you know, they know exactly what the hell that's about.
Smith does go down. We get to see a little bit of what ACR is all about at this point. He's really been playing well so far on Dust2, but here on Nuke, not finding the same luck. And it is going to be Titan now with a 9-round lead and 0 coming in for Vox Eminor. They will be able to buy, but I'm not sure.
They're going to keep buying, basically. At this point, they have to buy nearly every round. I mean, they've run out of leeway in this round here, as we can see, down to 100, 400, 500 total bucks in the bank. But if they can get a plant, they will be able to get a full buy in the next round. They just need to keep putting the pressure on Titan at this point. Titan, in the meantime, are running away with it. I did like the idea. I really did like the idea of dropping through main like this, but. Yeah. With Kenny S out in the yard, he gets you mid-air and drops the bomb onto main roof. AZR is here, but if Kenny S were to kill AZR...
Yeah. It's not even Vox Eminor's fault. Cloud9 awoken the beast that is Kenny S, and now he's taking it out on the next opponent here. ACR will pick up two great kills. Existence falls, and so does Kenny, so maybe there's a chance right now. Scream is going to get the rifle out just in time, and Havoc sort of stuck in the pit or in the hut here. He's going to be going down, and it's a 2-on-2, the first opening for Vox. Can they really make this happen? JKS and Sponge are left, and there's a great headshot from JKS now down to Scream. 1-on-2, and he's actually going to drop right down in the vents here. They know exactly where he is. Bomber's going to go down. Can they do this?
He's looking for the headshot already, and Scream, he just taps, gets the flash, opportunity, goes for a spray and doesn't get a kill. That looked like a guaranteed one there on Sponge. That's odd, but in the end, Vox Eminor, they get their first round on the board.
Yes, very nicely done. I mean, ACR opening up with that double kill, not surprised that it's him doing it. He's also top fragging at the moment on the Vox Eminor team. Total in the game, it's Kenny with 14 kills. And that round started off like it was going to be another ridiculous round from Kenny, but they managed to shut him down.
Okay, well, look at this, actually. The state of the money right now. If we bring up the scoreboard once again very quickly here, we can look. Not a whole lot of bank left on Titan. They lose one round. They buy up again, but they do not have a whole lot left in the bank. Havoc is going to find Smith, and Kenny is missing shot after shot. Nade comes in to finish him off, and Scream lets him buy, but then the triple mow down, make it 4. Existence with the quad kill, and NBK to clean up the last.
After such a good opening, that's a real shame for Vox Eminor, because that looked like that was going to be a perfect start. Two kills coming in, including one of them on Kenny S, who's the top fragger, and then the Belgian captain just decides, well, enough is enough.
That'll do.
You had your fun.
That'll do. That's brutal, that position played there. I mean, it looked so good for a second there for Vox Eminor. Kenny S not landing shots. Smith's picked off immediately in main. You're thinking, okay, then they've got two frags. They can really play this. And then Existence comes out of nowhere and blindsides them.
Yeah, and just to go through really quickly how the economic system works, because we do have a lot of new listeners watching, and all of you already know it, all of the viewers that have been watching for a long time, just enjoy the game for a little bit here. But what really happens is, once you start losing rounds, if you lose 5 consecutively, your round loss bonus builds up to, it's about 3,400. And that's after 5 rounds. So Vox Eminor, they win a single round and it resets down to 1,400. And that's where they're at right. That's why they have to eco. And that's as bad as it gets, basically.
Yeah, it's so, worst case scenario time. Yeah. That really is. And well, Kenny is having a field day out in yard right now. Drops the bomb down. into yard. He knows exactly where he is, where it is at this point. NBK is going to be the one to have the fun now. But Existence has the SCAR 20, and he doesn't believe in having fun. Look at that. Look at that. He's just taking it out on him. No mercy.
Yeah. I want to imagine that Titan have just... They forgot about the fact that they're playing Vox. They're just pretending this is Cloud9 instead. They want to get back and fight them again.
This is like, damn you, Hiko. Damn you, Hiko.
No. Tomorrow, Cloud9 is going to be fighting Dignitas. And the loser of that match is going to be fighting whoever wins here. And we're going to be able to cover all of those games as well. So it is going to be great fun. Moving into the 13th round, we'll see. Vox Eminor still not out of it, but they need to pick up, I would say, the next three rounds. They need to make this 11-4. I think they need, at the very minimum, four rounds. It's a really rough challenge. Titan on Nuke, and you get to start on the terrorist side, and you lose the gun round.
Yeah, that's exactly. That's about as brutal as it gets. Kenny just continues to dominate in yard, racking up frags. He believes in padding stats, and he's very good at it. Smith's not going to get anything there. Smith gets two. So Smith also, you know, he had a strong performance on the first map on Dust 2. He continues to want to make, you know, everybody who played the Pick'em Challenge happy. You know, every frag he gets, it's a point in the bank. But but Titan, they get 12 rounds on the board now, and Vox Eminor, well, the time is nigh. They have to just step up right here and get the remaining two rounds in this half. Three rounds on T side of Nuke, it's feasible, but it ain't easy. I'm trying to think of a way to turn that around and basically be like, you know, it's feasible, but really, the odds of doing it, well, it's like Cloud9 odds, basically.
Yeah, except you're on Nuke, so it's, I mean, it can get even more tricky. If this finish is 14-1, yeah, it's even more sorts, I would say. Kenny looking up here, seeing if he can pick up a kill on ACR, who is just about to peek, and Kenny's ready and doesn't hesitate for even a second there.
Instant, and Smith's has taken up his position below Silo as well. Sometimes Titan do this to change it up. They draw the attention back with Kenny. I mean, Smith is just waiting to catch them as they try and rush in for the punish as soon as those smokes go down, essentially. Vox Eminor, though, they don't want anything to do with Kenny anymore. Kenny, though, is not done with the party. He's one of those guys, those annoying guests. You want it to be the end. You know, it's over. You're tired. Go home. Kenny, he's still partying. He's still dancing to music in the living room. He just doesn't shut up. He's going to come and find you and bring the party to you.
Things are not really looking all that good at the moment. They're going to be rushing into the bomb site with 40 seconds left, and Havoc will pick up Smith's. A great start here. Scream. Instant headshot on JKS, looking for a second one, and he's going to actually get some help from Kenny to pick that one up. Top Gun will finally get him with the kill here, but it's Sponge alone. 1-on-3, 6 HP, and if NBK hadn't finished him, that grenade would have from Kenny. That's 13-1, and Semler, the problem is that as much as we've been crediting Vox with trying different things to find an opening, right now they have nothing they can go back to and say, oh yeah, remember that one round that worked? Mm-hmm. The one round that worked involved some really great pickoffs on Kenny and Smith's outside, I think. And it's not really a strategy that works in that sense. It's you have to get the pickoffs. And that's not something you can just, you know, get.
Oh, they've gone for clean strats. They've gone for clean strats that haven't worked. They've gone for picks that haven't worked. It really is brutal. It's almost like Hellraiser's Epsilon at this point, the first match of the day that we had this morning, where Hellraisers were just in this position where it's just like, what can we do that actually works against this team? Because they are not missing shots. Kenny, again, gets two in the yard. They can't handle him. And NBK now is just going to have a field day. Existence is still giggling like a schoolgirl with his SCAR 20, just lighting people up. And there you go, the final headshot of the round. 15 rounds. Titan take 14 of them. One round for Vox.
24-1-6 for Kenny. Yes, it's so stupendous.
Now, can you imagine like how badly I'm kicking myself right now because I didn't put him on my fantasy team? I took Guardian over Kenny.
Yeah,
I am so, because Kenny costs like an extra $400 or something. I was like, too expensive. I can't invest that much money in him.
Look, I mean, what to say? Sometimes you wonder what would happen if you put Kenny in a game like Quake and gave him a railgun just to see what would actually happen.
That would be, you know how you get like the little blue symbol, right? Where it's like, you know, like, oh, you get two kills and it's like excellent, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Kenny, like 90% right. Railgun accuracy.
Kenny just has that like constantly, basically. Like that thing just keeps going on to the point where he has to mute the voice because he actually can't hear the game sounds over the voice that just keeps saying.
for anyone that's, I guess, like, what, older than 25, Kenny's like, he's basically like, you know, that obelisk of Light in Command and Conquer, where you get too close, it makes like a really uncomfortable sound, and it saps your infantry. That's basically what Kenny is in that courtyard, just waiting, and he does like a sound, and then boom, they just get fried. No misses. That thing never misses. Second round is coming up in about 40 seconds, and obviously, Vox Eminor, they were the underdog in this group. They took an impressive amount of rounds against against Dignitas. Right now, they're up against a Titan who's looking for a little bit more than just revenge. They exited EMS1 in Katowice by, you know, not making it out of the groups. They never made it to the playoffs. This time, it sort of feels like they're hell-bent on that not happening again.
Pretty much. Well, you're going into tomorrow, and then you're talking about the three guys that... Well, the three teams, I mean, right now it's obviously not over because Vox Eminor, they're going to be on the CT side. If they can win the pistol round, well, then they could do the same thing to Titan. But you could very well be looking at three top eight teams, basically, like top eight in the world right now. Three of those teams are going to be playing in this group tomorrow. Like Cloud9, Dignitas, and Titan, it's kind of just like as good as it gets right there in a group. And one of them will be gone. So... let's see here, as we start the second half now going into this pistol round. Titan, this is the kind of opportunity basically for Titan to just kind of use a fun strat, basically. Like something that could work one off and just end this right here before Vox are able to get any kind of room. Vox actually believe in the fire though, Anders. They believe in keeping warm, which is weird because they come from Australia. Again, it's very hot down there.
It definitely is, but I mean, I guess fire could be good, dealing with some of all the snakes and the spiders and stuff, you know.
I'm amazed that nothing, that like they haven't burned that island to a crisp yet.
Well, all right, they're going to be pushing in towards the ramp room, and Top Gun caught in the corner. It's going to go down, and there's going to be Existence picking up the shot. So that Molotov doesn't really do a lot of anything, because they just push right through it and get the kills anyway. JKS down to 12 HP, and it's him and Sponge left trying to hold this in a 2-1-5. And this could be a 16-1 victory for Titan, as they are going to be just stomping all over this map, even trying to knife JKS,
oh,
which
scream.
Is... oh, you know, a little bit of attitude coming out here from Titan.
I'm wagging my finger right now. You guys can't see, but that right there, I would have loved to have seen him get killed for that, because come on, you don't knife. You don't knife like that.
Well,
you knife when you're Doja and you sneak up behind two guys and it's just like amazing. You're like full ninja mode. Okay, then you go for the knife. But like that, I don't know.
Again, I think Titan have forgotten about the fact that they're playing against Vox. They're just pretending this is Cloud9. They're thinking, what if I could have knifed Semphis instead? That would have been great. All right, now we go into the 17th round. The score is 15-1, and it's match and map point for Titan. Vox Eminor have pistol armor, and that's about it. It could be a bit of a brutal map here for the last one of the day.
Yeah, full circle. Potentially, we come full circle here. We started the day with a 16-1. Do we end the day with a 16-1? Titan. All right. They're on the brink. Kenny has taken fire, but he's going to find AZR, and that's going to be the first frag, opening up ramp. So now Titan have a little bit of room to maneuver here. They're actually getting under hell as well, so they can actually come through two different angles towards that ramp room if they so choose. Smith is going to be the one on point out here. Nobody to boost. He's looking for his team. He's alone.
I'm throwing a flashbang.
And it's very lonely right now. Is he going to be able to find anything here, though? He's looking for the man who would have rotated to cover ramp. Looking to sneak up behind him. He's going to be checking all the angles, but nobody is here. So Titan now have a whole lot of information to go off of, in fact.
Yeah, they do. They can guess that a lot of the Vox members are going to be up in that A-bomb site, and as a result, well, they go to the B-bombs instead. They don't want to risk anything at all, and they still have a couple of flashbangs to work with, too, on that terrorist side. Havoc with a good pickup, but now they're going to get double peaked, and actually, they do come up with some good kills here. JKS making it work and turning it into a 3-on-3.
That bomb has been planted now. NBK gets a running gun onto Sponge, and that's going to clean up ramp. But now Havoc has that Galil. Last man alive, taking the fight, 1v3, finds one kill, takes out Smiths. 1v2 now, NBK peeks at ramp, gets back around the corner just in the nick of time though, and Havoc, no fear, gets NBK too. Now into the 1v1, Kenny S alive on the site, but it's not gonna be enough. Vox Eminor will get 16-1 in this loser match, and they will be going home with that map haunting them. Titan, they have fought their way through to day two.
Yes, they have. I'm a little bit sorry I am for Vox Eminor, because they are actually a very cool team.
Yeah.
But it's hard to prove when you're up against, in a group like this, I would say the most difficult group out of all of them, basically. It's really tough to do much of anything. What I really wish, I'd be so cool if we could keep Vox Eminor, if we could keep them for a couple of weeks and have them play, you know, online matches and stuff like that in Europe, just because I would love to see how they fare if they get a little bit of chance to catch up with the European scene. Because that's one of the big challenges they have being from Australia, is that they practice against other Australian teams.
They're
and it's not quite the
Australian
same.
Teams. They have horrible net as well, so it's tough for them to connect. I mean, still, Vox putting up a strong fight, 9 rounds versus Dignitas, 10 rounds total essentially throughout their group. But that's how brutal this tournament is. It's GSL double elimination format in the groups. 2 wins, you're through. 2 losses, you're done. You're out. So Vox Eminor, they lose their 2 matches today. That's going to be it for their tournament. But they're going to be able to be here. I mean, anyway, it feels kind of bad, but it's like, you know, they're going to be here to enjoy the rest of the tournament.
What a way to start off this absolutely incredible tournament. That is half of the group stage done. Tomorrow, guys, we're going to do the winner's match and then the follow-up deciding match to decide what 2 teams are going to be making it out. We already have 1 team out, but 1 more has to exit from each group, and another 2 have to make it through. And actually, if we can bring up the group here before we end for today, we definitely got to do that. So here are all the groups. Right now, we know that Wolf, London Conspiracy, that team and Vox Eminor are all out. So they're the bottom seeds here, and it sort of follows true in that sense. We still have 1 more team to exit from the last 3, and 2 have to make it through.
Exactly.
And right now, nobody is through at this point.
Nobody. It's all going to come down to tomorrow. We don't miss a single game tomorrow either.
Nope.
We start here 9:30.
10, I believe so.
I believe. Well, 9:30, I believe, is going to be the first match here. It's the 9:30 CET.
I think we're going to have to. We're bringing Scoots as well.
Yeah, Scoots is going to be involved tomorrow. I believe he's going to be hosting. So it's not just going to be the Room on Fire crew, because Ben is here obsing as well. But Scoots, we're going to add him into the mix. We're going to get a bit of the Freedom Bird flavor.
Yeah.
And see, you know, how that works out. But that is going to be bright and early tomorrow, 9:30 in the morning here at Gamescom. We will not be in the ESL studio tomorrow. We will be live at the event, which is going to be sick too.
And we're slowly ramping it up, of course, come playoffs. Saturday and Sunday, we're going to bring in the likes of Pansy and Tosspot and Richard Lewis and obviously Scoots as well. So it's going to be just great fun.
Yeah.
You don't want to miss that at all. It's going to get better and better. Invite all your friends and get them watching tomorrow. Bright and early, I know, but it's worth it in the end.
Oh, yeah. And shout out to all the North Americans who woke up or stayed up.
And the Australians for supporting their teams like that. Definitely.
Seriously,
cool.
You guys, heroes.
Absolutely. And if you have any kind of feedback for us, then please don't hesitate to contact us on Twitter. Is the easiest place to do it. So that's at VendettaGo for Vendetta, who's been doing all the observing and doing a really good job. It's at OnFire Semran, OnFire Anders for the two of us. And you can definitely go and do that. And it's right there, of course. So there we go. Go and you know, follow us on Twitter, and you'll be able to easily get in contact with us, and we'll try and do our best to reply to it. For now, guys, thanks for tuning in. You've made this an incredible day for all of us, so we're so thankful for it, and obviously looking forward to seeing you tomorrow.
Yeah, have a fantastic evening. Be here tomorrow morning, bright and early, same channel. We'll see you then.